It's your girl Kirsten T, and I'm back again with another video. Today's video is going to be a makeup tutorial, y'all. Big shouts out to one of my best friends in the whole wide world, Audra, for being my model. All right, guys, I hope you like it, and I'll see you soon with the finished product. Mwah.
All right, y'all, let's get this thing started. So what I'm doing here is I'm filling my girl's eyebrows in with a MAC eyeshadow in the color Espresso. I use this pretty much every day for just a nice natural brow. I feel like it gives me the best looking brows that I've ever had in my life. And moving right along to the next step, I will be taking a makeup palette from Macy's, actually. Crazy, right? And I will be going over the powder that I just filled in, and I will be outlining her eyebrow. This just gives more definition to the brow and makes it look more pumping, you know what I'm saying? So here you just see me going back in on the other side and doing the same exact step that I did on the first side with this one right here. Alright, so we're moving right along. Now I'm going in and concealing her brows using the Black Radiance double-sided concealer in the number CA8008. Now that I have both of her eyebrows concealed, I'm now taking a beauty sponge that I got from Ulta, and I am blending. Ladies, please never forget to blend. Alright, so now that I'm done with her eyebrows, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to color correct with my MAC Pro Conceal and Correct palette in the color Dark. Now, she doesn't have many imperfections, but I do see a little bit of hyperpigmentation around her mouth area that I want to clear up. Alright, so now that I'm done with the color correcting, I'm going to go right back in with my Black Radiance double-sided concealer, and I'm just going to clean that up and make sure that everything blends very, very well. I don't want you to see any traces of that orange, y'all. All right, so now what I'm gonna do to kind of set my concealer is I'm going to be going in using my Real Techniques setting brush as well as my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish Dark Deep Powder and just setting that so that I get no movement from my concealer. I don't need this to move at all. As Ajua takes a sip of her drink, she's so ratchet, y'all. Look at her. Gosh. All right, now this is my favorite part, y'all, highlighting time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in my True Complexion Contour Palette in the shade Medium to Dark from where? Y'all guessed it, Black Radiance, y'all. And I'm gonna go under Ajua's eyes to give him more awake look. Now what you're going to see me do is put the highlight color down the middle of her nose, the middle of her forehead, as well as the middle of her chin. Now what this does is it allows for our natural highlighted areas to show through even more to give that illuminating look. Shine, baby. So again, we're going in with our Ulta Beauty Blender and we are blending it out, sweetheart. Yes, we are making sure that there are no lines and that this is just a flawless look. Let's keep this train rolling, y'all. So I'm going in with my LA Cosmetics Pro Concealer in the color Espresso, and I'm just going to contour the sides of her nose, underneath her cheekbones, on her jawline, as well as her forehead. So now I'm going in with, of course, an Ulta Beauty Blender, and I'm going to blend out that contour, making sure that there are no harsh lines in between the highlight and the contour. I want it to blend perfectly. Alright, and to set that, I'm going to go in with my powdered True Complexion Contour Palette in the shade Medium to Dark. Using my Real Techniques setting brush, I'm just going to dab it under her eyes, making sure that it gets a chance to kind of soak in and take away all of that excess oil. We'll be right back. Alright, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back in with my Black Radiance double-sided concealer stick, and I'm going to put that on her eyelid so that the colors that I put on her eyes will give more of a color show off. Alright, now I'm just going to set her eyes using the True Complexion Contour Palette in the shade Medium to Dark. Now, going in with my Real Techniques blending brush, I'm going to be going into my Smashbox Cover Shot Bold Eye Palette using the color Fling for her crease. So now what I'm doing is I'm going back into that Smashbox Cover Shot Bold Eye Palette, and I will be using the color Techno on her lid. And I will be doing this using a brush from BH Cosmetics. Now I'm going to be using my MAC Blending Stippling Brush from the collection Great Gatsby, and I'm going to be going back into that Smashbox Bold Eye Palette in the color Techno. So now, I'm going to be going right back into that Smashbox palette, and I'm going to take the color Fling on my Real Techniques blending brush, and I'm going to blend out the color Techno with the color Fling. And here you see me using my BH Cosmetics brush, going in again with the color Stormy, and just cleaning everything up so the color payoff is perfect. So trying to record doing eyeliner and getting the right angle is a work all in itself. So I just have some shots of me trying to perfect her line, trying to make it as neat, clean, crisp as possible. So now I'm just going to take my Real Techniques setting brush, and I'm going to wipe away that excess powder that I put under Ajua's eyes from my Black Radiance True Complexion Contour Palette. So now I'm taking a blending brush from Sonia Kajouk, I hope I said that right, and I'm going back into my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the color Dark Deep, and I'm going to blend everything together. Now using my Real Techniques blending brush as well as my contour powder, I'm going to take the darkest color and contour her nose. Now using an angled brush that I got from a drugstore, I will be using the Milani Baked Powder Blush. I'm not really sure what color it is, but all of the details will be linked down below. Now I'm going to take my BH Cosmetics brush, and I'm going to dip into the Artisan Color Baked Bronzer in the color Flawless. This is from Black Radiance, and I love it. It's a highlight, so I'm going to use it on her cheeks. I'm going to use it in the middle of her nose, on the button of her nose, as well as the middle of her forehead. Now I'm taking my Mario Badescu Rose Water Setting Spray and spraying it all over Ajua's face. Now, for Ajua's lips, I will be using the Nika K True Matte Lipstick in the color Millbrook. And that just about does it, y'all. Anything that I forgot will be added in the detail box below.